Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera. Hari ini berkuat kuasanya kadar sifar bagi cukai barangan dan perkhidmatan GST dan pastinya harga barangan di pasaran menjadi tumpuan rakyat sama ada langkah diputuskan kerajaan mendorong penurunan harga atau sebaliknya. Baiklah, seterusnya kita akan ke laporan pada jam 11.30 pagi nanti. Saya Noel Fagani, salam hormat dan salam ceria.
Hello there, thanks for joining us. I'm Shafiqa Razali and welcome to 7 Edition's News Set. These are the news updates of the hour. The Malaysian Retail Chain Association, MRCA, will be donating RM200,000 to the Tabung Harapan Malaysia Fund as a way to show the association's spirit of patriotism and support for the government to rebuild the country. And those are the updates for now. Tune into 7 Edition tonight at our new time slot at 11. I'm Chef Karazali. Have a lovely day.
表示政府将过滤在大选中为国政助选的公务员，确定他们的忠诚度，但他强调不意对付这些公务员。消费税今天正式从6%归零，贸销部全国出动检查销售情况，并给予商家1个月的宽限期，让他们重新标价。 大马希望基金所筹措的款项短短一天内翻了1倍，从昨天的700多万到如今突破了1000万令吉。不过网络上也出现了一些假户头。6月1号，星期五，全新的月份，全新的时段，欢迎收看 NTV7
怀疑新闻。你好，我是周秀阳。你好，我是陈薇薇。一个小时的内容，双主播阵容带您紧贴国内外时事。首先来看政治新闻。是的，怀疑新闻来到这里告一段落，非常谢谢大家守着 NTV7 怀疑新闻。我是周秀阳，我是陈薇薇，约定您明天同样时间再见。
Bersama saya Farah Nabilah Wazir, antara paparan utama. Kadar sifar GST bermula, peniaga gagal pamer tanda harga. Juga rabies di Sarawak ragut nyawa ke-10. Dan 14 dipercayai lanun di berkas selepas rompak kapal kargo MT Pride. Bakat luar biasa, seorang remaja di Belgium bermain biola dengan menghasilkan bunyi haiwan. Kami kongsikan bagi mengakhiri edisi 7. Saya Farah Nabilah Wazir, salam hormat dan salam ceria.
9 on 7 edition. 14 robbers arrested off southern Johor waters. 15 nabbed for planning lone wolf attacks in KL. And arrest warrant issued against Jamal Yunus. Catch these stories and more at 11 p.m.
Today's新闻焦点。 取消马新高铁计划引发争议，敦马表示他只是履行西盟的大选承诺。移民局表示没有沙巴前首长穆沙和红衫军领袖加马的出境记录，两人已经被列入黑名单。警方逮捕15名恐怖嫌疑人，其中一人原本准备在大选时开车撞投票中心。详情留守稍后5点开始的一个小时华语新闻。
Hello there, thanks for joining us on 7 Edition at our new 11 p.m. time slot and our new set in Studio 7. I'm Azlin Energy and these are tonight's headlines. Now it's summertime and a zoo in South China's Guangdong province on Friday made good use of ice to help their giant pandas beat the scorching heat. From ice beds to iced fruits, the visuals wrap up tonight's bulletin. I'm Azlin Energy, thanks for tuning in and see you next time.